everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. As we head towards kickoff, two quarterbacks will be on the field today trying to push their team to victory. It's Rivers' Chargers going up against Dak Prescott's Cowboys.
Thank you, Larry. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Lone Star State and Mammoth AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas. A moment ago, here was the scene with the Cowboys emerging from their tunnel. It was loud. It's still loud. We're ready for football as the Cowboys get set to match up. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line with the Los Angeles Chargers. Here's the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. Ezekiel Elliott gonna take it the distance. The 20. Touchdown, Cowboys. Ezekiel Elliott, 76 yards. And the Cowboys have taken the early lead. The first play from scrimmage. Some of these people haven't even taken their seat.
That's what is commonly known as a fast start. That's what my horse racing friends would say. They caught a flyer out of the gate, and guess what? They're in the lead now.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Rivers on first down, looking for Allen. He's got him on the slant. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 18 big yards on that one, and a Charger first.
Defense gives up a touchdown on the opening drive. Offense, you got to want to get out there and get those points back right now.
And that's a sharp throw there to get this drive off to a good start. In motion left goes Allen. Now a first carry for Melvin Gordon. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and it'll be second and very short.
Really tough drive, but that run helped salvage something there because now there's something positive that came out of it. They got to see good blocking, good push by the offensive line, wide receivers trying to get involved, a good run by the back. And now maybe it'll be a catalyst for them to look at going forward, watching it on tape. Maybe they can keep incorporating that type of a run into their offense.
And they went the wrong way there, losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. That'll wind up going for a loss of four. And that'll lead here to a third down. Now the first carry for Brandon Oliver. And he's got enough for the first across midfield to the 48. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
So right now what I'm seeing an offense just firing off the ball a lot quicker than they can react. And not only that, they're sustaining the blocks too. I'm seeing guys get 6-7 yards downfield before there's even a hint of contact.
20! Almost unstoppable on the ground there as that one is good for 39.
I hope we give enough respect to the big guys up front because they have been getting it done on this drive. The holes have been large, and they've been barreling through them, picking up first downs.
To throw, Rivers. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete.
They'll put a check mark in the box where the defense coordinator was saying, how well can we stay with these receivers if we're in man coverage? Because he just did it on that one. Force the incompletion. That allowed him to get bolder with his pass rush, won't it?
Absolutely. Freeze up your guys elsewhere. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
partner, I know we're in a goal-to-go situation, but my goodness, think about running the ball here. Not even a thought, is it?
Defensively, they're in a prime spot.
And I think...
And he takes it in for a Charger touchdown. Antonio Gates from 10 yards out. And the Chargers are an extra point away from tying this thing up. Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time. A lot of people see that position as a fallback. Throw it to them when all else fails? Not at all. This guy can make plays, and that's exactly what he just did.
Yeah, play here for a touchdown. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. The offense for the Cowboys now working their way back onto the field. And coming off a one-play drive that was so deflating for the defense, what's their mentality? How do they rally here and stop this offense?
Well, hopefully there's some determination that sets in, because they weren't ready to go on the last one. Give all the credit to the offensive guys for getting it done, but to allow a run of that length, that's just not being prepared. So now, are they determined? Are they ready to read their keys and make the proper plays?
And we'll see how determined they are. On second down, Elliott. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs.
And Brandon, you know that expression? He just does what he does. It sounds trite, doesn't it? But in this case, it's perfectly apt. This is one of the better runners in the NFL. And all he does is just find avenues, find ways to pick up key first downs and big runs.
Sliding out of the pocket, going right side. He has Winton. And he'll be out of bounds up past the 45. That one goes for 13 yards and it moves the sticks.
Sometimes it's designed, and sometimes you just have to know when to leave the pocket and move and make something happen. And on that play, he was able to get on the run and was still accurate throwing the football.
And this one caught by Dez Bryant. And he's finally taken down, and it's a big gain there on what will turn out to be the final play of this first quarter. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10.
Take four.
They go play action here on first down. And this is caught at the 8. Touchdown, Cowboys! Cole Beasley, 30 yards. And the Cowboys have taken the lead. And there they got him the ball. Just get it to him, let him do the rest.
You know, he probably said that to his quarterback as he broke the huddle. I like the play call. Just get it to me. I'll take care of the rest of it.
Helping out his rack, right? RAC.
Run after catch. And he loves that, and he's going to carry that in at contract time.
On the return, it's Isaiah Burse. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. The Charger offense making their way back out there. And now last drive, so successful with the ground game, ending in a touchdown. Do you stick with that formula?
That would be the number one thing you would think of, but so many guys now would look at it and say, we've got them set up so well for play action, now's the time to take a shot.
Yeah.
But you know, there was a big time coach in the state of Ohio who once said, if you throw the ball, if you put it in the air, three things can happen, and two of them are bad.
Is that Woody
Hayes? He would have kissed it on the ground.
It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4. Now on 2nd down, finds the open man. It's Mike Williams, and they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. A 10-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Charger first down. Now Gordon on 1st down, and he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be 2nd down.
Well, forget about finding a lane there. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. Probably fortunate he was able to hold on to the football.
Second down, Rivers. It's caught on the right side, Williams. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains. Now a play fake here on first down. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Taco Charlton in there to sack him for a loss of 6. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result? Sack. Quarterback gets hit.
And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
Let's give some credit to the defensive guys on that play. Able to bat that one away. Sure looked like they were trying to hit the corner route.
And some changes here as the D-line separates some. Third and long for Rivers. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
It's a lot of contact going on there. And in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. Rivers is going to stay out there. They're going to try for this thing on fourth down. From the gun, Rivers gets it to Benjamin. It's caught, and he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line. And they get 28 yards on that one, and the Chargers are going to have a first down. To play here in the first half. We're back to Arlington right after this timeout. Rivers now to throw on first down. Under pressure, and he'll go down back at the 26-yard line. DeMarcus Lawrence in there to bring him down for a loss of 7. Now a second down throw for Rivers. Had his hands on it, but dropped it. The rookie making a little bit of a rookie mistake. Third down. Fair to say, hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know. He's got to throw it better. Got to get more help. Obviously one that should have been caught. They got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can make some progress in this one.
Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Chidobe Awuzie with a pick. And they get the football, but not much on the return here as he stopped at the 7-yard line.
Well, it's third and long, and you've got a few different ways to play it offensively. But this is not the type of offense that's going to wave the white flag. They're going to keep chucking it. And this time, it results in an interception.
And not great starting field position here for the offense. On the counter, Elliott. And an alley to run. And he'll find some room to get this up to about the 14. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
And Beasley with it over the middle. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue. On 1st and 10, Prescott. He's got his man on the crossing route. And finally out of bounds down near the 10-yard line. A big play there just before halftime. 58 yards. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's 1st and goal. Now Elliott. And he's going to bowl his way down to about the 1 yard line. A good red zone run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second and goal. They'll try to run it in with Elliott, and they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. Calling a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's third and goal.
And a nice job defensively to keep him out of the end zone. He's trying to get a second touchdown already in the first half.
They had that one earlier, was bidding for a second. Now on fourth and inches, they're going to want to talk this over. We get a timeout as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. A field goal would make it a two-score game, but they're going to go aggressive. They're going to try this thing on fourth and goal. Prescott. And that is caught. It's Witten for the Cowboy touchdown. Jason Witten in the final seconds of the first half. And the Cowboys will add on to their lead. It's good, and it is now 21-7. Now to kick this one away. This will be taken in at the one. The Chargers getting set to go. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This is fielded at the goal line. Oh, now a hit and a loose football. It's picked up by the Cowboys. And he will score. Touchdown, Cowboys. A big play there. Taking it in. And the Cowboys will extend their lead. And now it's blocked. And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. This will be taken in at the one. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this is a real,
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. A gain of 6 there on first.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they could do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks, those guys are worth their weight in gold.
Again, it's Rivers. And he's got a man open. That's Allen. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. The Charger first down. Rivers hooking up with Allen. Here's Rivers. It's caught at the 10. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. An excellent pickup of 34 yards. First down, Rivers. Buying time to his left. Thrown across his body and it's intercepted. Chidobe Awuzie with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. First possession of the third quarter, an interception.